Join us as we look at what NASA's Opportunity rover found on Mars. Explore, examine, sleep, repeat. The Mars Exploration Rover mission involved sending two rovers to Mars in 2003. One was Opportunity, aka MERB, and nicknamed Oppy, while the other was named Spirit. They launched close together, Spirit on June 10, 2003, and Opportunity on July 7, 2003. They landed in January 2004 on opposite sides of the planet's equator, deployed instruments, and started to look for answers concerning Martian areology, which is like geology, but on Mars instead of Earth. The entire trip took 200 days for Opportunity. Its mission was to determine the likelihood of Mars ever having been an environment that could have supported life. The best way to do that would be to determine if water had ever existed on the surface at some point. In the rocky outcropping immediately surrounding the landing site, the rock layers rose and fell irregularly, indicating that some sort of flow had disrupted them. Water? Maybe, but it could also have been lava or wind. Opportunity used its rock grinding tool to wear away the surface. It took microscopic images and discovered voids in the rock that were spaces where a mineral had been eroded away. It seemed the missing mineral was soluble, and chemical analysis revealed that there were hydroxide ions in the remaining rock. That was a very strong indication that water had been present when the rock formed. First evidence. It did more soil analysis, spotting thousands of small round rocks just a centimeter or two in diameter, whose color made viewers think of blueberries. The name stuck. Full of iron oxide, it argued heavily for the presence of water. Oppy then headed off to Endurance Crater at the breakneck top speed of up to 5 centimeters per second. After 84 Martian days called sols, each of which is approximately 40 minutes longer than an Earth day, Opportunity finally made it to its next target, Endurance Crater. Speaking of endurance, at this point it should be noted that the entire mission was expected to last 90 sols. When that date occurred, since both rover twins were still performing well, the mission was extended. This would happen several more times as the rover followed the red line seen in this photo from top to bottom, covering 28 miles total. Ultimately, Opportunity would end up operating for more than 8 Martian years, or 15 Earth years. The mission continues. It stayed at Endurance Crater for 180 sols, examining the structure of all the exposed bedrock around the interior rim. From the results, researchers were able to determine that not only had water been present, but it had come and gone many, many times. After that, it was time to move on, and this meant a detour to examine its own heat shield that was not too far away. This was found and examined, but much more interesting was a big rock sitting nearby. On all this otherwise smooth land, what was a rock doing here? As it turned out, it was a meteorite. This was the first time a meteorite had been discovered on another planet. More firsts for Opportunity. Now it set off for its next crater encounter. But on Sol 445, it ran into trouble and sunk 4 of its 6 wheels into a 30-centimeter deep sand dune. They sent the problem to the practical laboratory on Earth with a duplicate of the rover and spent 20 days issuing instructions to Opportunity's twin to find the best way to escape. Carefully advancing over many days, Opportunity was finally able to escape on Sol 483. The tiny dune was appropriately named Purgatory, and Opportunity happily left behind as it continued its journey. EREBUS Crater. The next crater on the schedule was called EREBUS, but it was mostly sand, so it was too dangerous to enter. On Sol 744, Oppy visited an EREBUS feature called Payson Outcrop, and found features that indicated both wind and water actions in the finely divided layers. This was billions of years old and had both primary and secondary sedimentation features to support the wind-water theory. Shortly thereafter, there was a substantial dust storm that covered Oppy's solar panels and camera lenses, decreasing power and visibility quite significantly. It was at this point that scientists made a new discovery. Dust devils roam the surface of Mars. These are spinning columns of atmospheric gases, just like we have on Earth when you see leaves spinning around, and they were just enough to clean Oppy's solar panels. Soon, Oppy was back to full power. This happened many times over its journey, and without it, the rover would never have lasted as long as it did. Victoria Crater. Nearly 200 sols after leaving Erebus, it finally arrived at the 725-meter crater named Victoria, which was nearly three times the size of Endurance Crater. Oppy explored the rim for a bit to see if it could find a safe way down. Finally picked a spot on Sol 1200, but then had to last through a huge dust storm. It had to sit until Sol 1291 until it began to receive enough solar energy to fully recharge and could start down into the crater. Although it did collect some good scientific data, the information indicated that this crater was a poor candidate for ever having life potential. After more than 200 days around Sol 1500, Oppy headed out of the crater. Santa Maria Crater. It took until Sol 2449, December 2010, for it to reach Santa Maria Crater, a total of 1,000 sols of traveling since leaving Victoria Crater. This beat several old endurance records, and the mission had now gone on more than 27 times its original intended length. Sadly, during this time, Oppy's sibling rover Spirit had died trapped in a sand dune, with two burned-out wheel motors. Santa Maria was important to researchers because there was already evidence that hydrated minerals, such as sulfur, existed. This would indicate long-term standing water, not merely periodic floods, suggesting the existence of a real ocean. Oppy spent 3 months here taking samples so the scientists would have years' worth of data to analyze. Finally, it left to head to the main attraction of the mission, Endeavour Crater. Endeavour Crater. This 22-kilometer-wide crater was the Great Hope for Opportunity's mission. The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter had spotted what it determined were probably clays around Endeavour Crater. Clays form in the presence of water, and this was the solid evidence of a real ocean that Oppy was seeking. It was a long trip, but if this proved out, it would make it all worthwhile. The rover arrived on Sol 2709. There was no need to enter the huge crater, since the clays had been spotted on the outside of the rim, and there were plenty of features to examine while they sought clay evidence. Here, Oppy found a large rock, subsequently determined to be ejecta from deeper beneath the surface, possibly caused by a meteorite strike or, less likely, an eruption. It had igneous rock and metamorphic rocks blended together. It also had high concentrations of bromine and zinc. This suggested that it had been awash in hot water from deeper down in the crust. Ooh, shiny. Nearby, a photo showed an unusual white stripe on the surface, a pretty stark contrast to the dusty red surface. Upon investigation, it turned out to be gypsum, a combination of calcium and sulfur. This seemed to be proof positive that there was water on the surface, and that it had ended up in a subsurface crack where the two minerals interacted to make gypsum. Now, millennia later, it lay exposed on the surface, practically screaming water. Finally, the rover got into the area where the clays were likely to appear. It was Sol 3057 when it found blueberries again, although a much different variety this time. They looked like peas floating in a bowl of soup. Instead of being loose on the surface like ball bearings, they were half submerged in the quite solid rock, and in several cases, the outer surface had been worn away, revealing the interior. The Piece de Resistance. Espérance was the name given to the rock found next, because the word means hope in French. It was very white compared to the surroundings. When it was tested, it turned out to be high in aluminum and silica, but lacking in high concentrations of most other minerals. In other words, it was clay, something only existing when minerals combine in water. Essentially, they had found the holy grail for this mission. Who would have expected it to be so obvious? You have a big white rock the size of your head sitting in the middle of a darker background. Could it have been easier? Maybe if it had been sitting right at the landing site, but they would have missed so many other adventures. What it did prove, however, was that non-basic, non-acidic water had existed here on Mars in large quantities. That was the exact proof they were looking for. Finally convinced they had perfected results, they moved on to find a winter spot where they could keep the batteries charged. Solander Point. they began the journey to their wintering spot at Solander Point, arriving around Sol 3400. The journey continued south, and the scientists realized that they were going to reach 26 miles, the official length of a proper marathon. They decided to name the next valley Marathon Valley to celebrate the amazing distance traveled by the durable rover. On Sol 4078, Oppy entered Marathon Valley and did some extensive exploring lasting another 1,000 days. The last word. Just ahead of a major dust storm, Opportunity entered Perseverance Valley. It was overtaken by the weather, which probably covered it with dense dust so that it couldn't recharge its batteries, and was last heard from on Sol 5111, more than 15 years after its initial landing. NASA tried for months to reconnect, but finally called it quits. Opportunity's final message was data, which roughly translated said, "Power is low. It's getting dark." We shouldn't be sad at the loss. It did its job 5,679% better than expected. It set a Mars distance record of 220 meters traveled in one day. It discovered hematite in many locations, hinting at water. It sent us 217,000 plus images, and many were 360-degree views. It ground away at rocks to let us see the interiors. It used a little brush to dust off surfaces so they could be analyzed with spectrometers and other more complex examination techniques. Most of all, it made a very good case for there having been a real ocean on Mars at one time, and that there had been plenty of, albeit shallow, water on the surface. It fulfilled its prime directive. NASA's last message to Opportunity was actually a piece of music from famed singer Billie Holiday called "I'll Be Seeing You," which was a fitting tribute. Nice job, Oppy. Do you think we'll ever hear from Opportunity again? Let us know in the comments below, and then check out this other video.